Hello student, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Neeraj Dwivedi from TERI, the Energy and Resources Institute, New Delhi. Today we are going to discuss about a module, Increasing Self-Life of Fruits and Flowers under paper Plant Biotechnology and Crop Improvement. So student, in this module, I will talk about significance of fruits, self-life of fruits and flowers, genetic modifications, studies, their outcome and future directions. So studies of increasing self-life of fruits and flowers. With the increasing bird population, the demand of foods is increases. Although from last 5 decades, global fruit production is growing as with increasing population, but still 1 billion persons of the world are scraveny because of food insecurity. Ripening associated softening is a major factor limiting fruit self-life and storage, and thus contributes to the tons of crop loss. In fact, several attempts have been made to control ripening process. For delaying ripening, major focus has been on the manipulation of ethylene production. Self-life is the length of time that a commodity may be stored without becoming unfit for use or consumption. A number of approaches has been used for the enhancing fruit and flowers self-life, that is plant mutagenesis, plant transformation studies, proteome profiling, allele mining, genetic engineering studies, recombinant DNA technology, molecular breeding, marker assisted selection, next generation sequencing, RNA interference, and more recently CRISPR-Cas9 system. Among these, next generation sequencing, nanotechnology, RNA interference, and CRISPR-Cas9 have coming up as a new technology for the crop improvement according to future needs. So now we will talk about increasing self-life of fruits. So the main limiting factor for self-life and storage is excessive softening. To increase the self-life, plants modified for the expression and by varying the action of cell wall enzymes, which implicated in tissue softening and deterioration. The fruit ripening hormone, ethylene, biosynthesis has been disrupted for the delaying fruit ripening by the inhibition of genes which are involved in ethylene biosynthesis pathway. The self-life increases can be achieved by maintaining resistance to ethylene. In 1983, Murai et al. Reported an important breakthrough, developed a genetically modified sunflower by using a seed protein gene of French bean, and demonstrated that the expression of a potential gene to a taxonomically distinct family. So here we talk about a few major studies on tomato for enhancing self-life. In 1994, Calgene Monsanto, United Kingdom, developed a commercial transgenic, which is named as Flower Shower, fresh tomatoes by antisense technology using a gene encoding polygalacturonase enzymes that involves in cell wall softening during ripening. Transgenic fruit showed extended self-life and reduction in the ripening process of genetically modified tomato. Thereafter, Hamilton and Balcombe 1998 decreased autocatalytic ethylene synthesis pathway by downregulation of genes which involves for ethylene production pathway such as ACC oxidase or 1-aminocyclopropane-1-carboxylase synthase ACS gene, and downregulation of these two genes has been found efficient to enhance fruit self-life. Nambisan et al. 2010 developed a Solanum lycopersicum transgenic, and the transformed tomato fruits showed enhanced shelf life, decreased shriveling, and reduced decay symptoms growth with compared to the wild type. And the transgenic plants manipulated with yeast spermidine synthase gene under control of CMB35S constitutive promoter and EAT fruit ripening specific promoter, and the transgenic tomato also showed delayed senescence. In this slide you can see this is ethylene biosynthesis pathway. So all the major genes which involves in the pathway are there. It involves SAM, which is S adenosyl L-methionine, SAMS, which is SAM synthase, ACC and ACS gene, which I am just talked about, that these two genes are very important, and Hamilton and Volcombe et al., they have down-regulated these genes and increased the fruit shelf life. So there is also MTA, which is 5-methyladenosine, and MACC gene, which is 1-malolyl-ACC, and AMT genes are there. So this is the source of this biosynthesis figure is Poel and Stratton 2014. In this slide, in 2010, Dehmani Mardas et al. Developed melon fruits with increased shelf life using tilling approach. And they have targeted 11 genes that control ethylene synthesis and screen for induced mutations that promotes fruit with improved shelf life, and they concentrate in knocked out of a precise gene, which is CMACO1, and pointed out a very significant amino acid glycine at the position of 194, which is responsible for the fruit maturation. So in this study, this is Melli et al. In 2010, they have identified two potential targeted ripening specific N-glycoprotein modifying enzymes, which is alpha mannosidase, which is called alpha man in short, and beta D-N-acyl hexosaminidase, which is called beta hags, and the overexpression of alpha man and beta hags resulted in enhanced fruit softening, and their inhibition showed improved fruit shelf life, and N-glycines are reported to play an important role during fruit ripening, though the role of any particular enzyme is until now unknown. So in this figure you can see that this is control, and this is inhibition of alpha man and beta hex genes. So after 10 days, after 20 days, even after 45 days, you can see the shelf life of fruit has been increased in the alpha man RNAi and alpha and beta hex RNAi tomatoes, and control is already gone. In 2012, Behboudian et al. Using RNAi approach down-regulate the expression of ACC oxidase ACO1 gene in tomato to reduce ethylene production, which requires in regulation of fruit ripening and floral senescence. The tomato transgenic lines showed lesser ethylene production and enhanced fruit shelf life with compared to the control, and also decreased the level of firmness loss as a result of decrease in the activity of pectin, methyl esterase, and polygalacturones. More recently, CRISPR-Cas9 technique is a novel approach which is used to site-directed mutagenesis in a specific genome region. In 2015, Eto et al. Reported application of the CRISPR-Cas9 system to an efficient mutagenesis of the tomato genome and targeted the RIN gene, which is tomato ripening inhibitor gene, which encodes a transcription factor MATSBox regulating fruit ripening. The disruption of RIN gene produced incomplete ripening fruits, or you can say delayed ripening and permanently inhibiting ripening, in which red coloration was extensively lower than that of wild type. And the result authenticate the important function of RIN in ripening. So, student, we can see that in this slide, many studies have been listed for genetic engineering with either enhanced shelf life or nutritional status. So, the gene ID or gene name is listed here, and their functions, or you can say what type of genes are they, this is also listed here, and their biological process is also there. So it is a study done by Matas et al. 2009. So student, now we'll talk about increasing shelf life of flowers. Genetic engineering procedure had so far narrow impact in decorative horticulture field, though ornamental horticulture and predominantly floriculture are very well suited to the move forward of genetic engineering system. In horticulture industry, ornamental plants are well documented like financial, ecological, and good benefits. Ornamental plants gathered by European to exporters to the worldwide and breeders exploited the variant that could be built up from plant breeding, and the diversity of cultivated ornamental plants increased extremely. The first and foremost center of attraction of the color modification is very significant in cut flower, because of flower color is an important driver for new diversity development. In 1995, Steven et al. Developed genetic engineering carnation plant by using ACO gene from Dianthus caryophyllus senia through antisense technique, and these transgenic plants showed low ethylene production and delayed petal senescence. The target of genetic engineering for flower color alteration: plants having pigments in flower in a broad range of flavonoids, carotenoids, and betaines. By altering the flavonoid biosynthetic pathway through the transformation of novel genes, overexpression of particular key regulatory gene, or by down-regulation of genes, or silencing of the genes, co-suppression technology also can be used, antisense gene technology can also used, and recently CRISPR-Cas9 has also been implemented for that. Basically, researchers have been focused on the modification of either blue or red color, which is anthocyanin, or orange or yellow color, which is carotenoid, to generate a wide range of flower color, as well as to produce natural dyes for industrial purpose. In 1987, Moyer et al. First developed modified flower color by the application of genetic engineering, achieved by using the DFR, dihydroflavonoyl 4 reductase gene of maize in a petunia line. in which the modified petunia plant flower color lead to the formation of an orange pelargonidin producing petunia, and the plants turn out flowers with pale brisk color. In 1988, Von der Knoll reported CHS, which is chalcon synthase gene, which has been used for creation of pink color or white color flower in petunias, roses, chrysanthemum, and gerbera through sense and antisense gene with the manipulation of F305OH gene from petunia hybrid have been successfully generated transgenic violet carnations, which encodes a flavonoid necessary for the biosynthesis of delphinidin. Genetic engineering carnations containing the ETR1-1 gene under the control of CAMB35S promoter or floral beginning protein promoter FBP1, and these transformed showing delayed senescence at least by 6 days and maximum up to 16 days. Threefold enhancement in shelf life have been achieved through this technology. In 2008, Century et al. Identified the transcription factor regulating the anthocyanin pathway, and since extra in erudite of the spatial regulation of flavonoid biosynthesis and for genetic alteration, though transcription factor for upregulation and downregulation of pigment biosynthesis. Additionally, during the flower induction and initiation, the endogenous production and allocation of plant growth regulator like indole-3 acetic acid, abscisic acid, and indole-3 pyruvate may make possible bias to improved plan of utmost flower regularity and the excellence of ornament plant during harvest. Monsanto Seed Company from US, it is an agriculture biotech firm, has patented a product that will stop flowers wilting by altering their DNA by using reverse genetic engineering to prevent the natural damage of cells that take place once a plant is cut and enlarge their shelf life. The company filed a patent in 2016 for the product, which muffled the plant's DNA and stops the production of ethylene gas, which ripens fruit and rots petals. It then gets into the plant's DNA and strangles the EIN2 gene, which would otherwise trigger the production of ethylene. So in this slide, you can see the role of different gene for improved phenotype in genetically modified ornamental plants. So these all studies have been done for increasing shelf life or increasing color content of ornamental plants. So you can see that this is the name of gene, ROL-C, and it is isolated from Agrobacterium rhizogenes, which is a source of this gene. And the phenotype of this gene is doffed pelargonism and petunias. And this study has been done by Borse et al. 2004. And like the second gene is IPT gene, and it is isolated from Agrobacterium tumidifensis, and phenotype of this gene is increased branching and reduced internode length in chrysanthemum, and this study has been done in 2009 by Kodarkovskaya et al. And there is two more gene from Arabidopsis, which is ASL38, LBD41 gene and FT gene. And the results of the phenotypic result of these genes are flowers turn into multiple column pattern in Calcocia cristata, and FT gene is responsible for activate the floral identity of genes, promotes flowering in appropriate conditions. This study is done by Jung and Muller in 2009. Other gene is ACO or ACS coding gene, which is the source of this gene is carnation or apple, and phenotype is increased waste life in carnations. And this important study has been done by Zucker et al. In 2001. So next three genes was isolated from chrysanthemum, which is LS gene, AP1 gene, and ERS1 gene. And LS gene is responsible for less branching in chrysanthemum. AP1 gene is responsible for speeds up time to flowering in chrysanthemum. And ERS1 gene is a mutated gene, slows down yellowing of leaves in chrysanthemum. And this study is done by Nurumi et al. 2005. Some other studies are Kotuso Moto et al. In 2007. They have used F3-5H gene isolated from petunia or pansy, which is responsible for overexpression, produces blue flowers in combination with a silenced DOF gene in carnation and roses. Next gene is CHS gene, and one more gene, ANS, which is isolated from gentian. These genes, CHS gene, responsible for gene silencing, produces white flower in gentian. And this study is done by Nishihara and Nakatsuka in 2011. And ANS gene is responsible for gene silencing, produces pale blue flowers in gentian. And this study also did by Nakatsuka et al. 2008. Monsanto, a US-based biotech company, recently patented a new product in this year, works its way into DNA and stops production of ethylene gas in plants. Ethylene promotes the ripening of fruits and shedding of plants on flowers. This could be a huge boost for florists and industry with a massive weightage. So this flower has long shelf life, and this rose won't wilt also. And scientists create a flower which petals that stay green for a days. So now, students, we will let's discuss what we have learned from this module, that genetic engineering has the potential to be used as an efficient tool to deal with the various problems in agriculture and society. The appearance of transgenic platform concerning the beginning of defined DNA sequences into plant by human has quickly altered the surface of our planet by additionally increasing the gene pool used by plant breeders for crop improvement. Genetic modification is being used to decrease size losses due to biotic stresses, abiotic stresses, biofortification of food crop by enrichment with excellence protein, vitamins, micronutrients, carotenoids, anthocyanin, etc. Moreover, post-harvest stability of fruits and vegetables has also been increased significantly to decrease the post-harvest losses. Therefore, genetic engineering serves as a proficient tool to commence desirable uniqueness in plants in a rapid and precise way. In spite of allied biosafety issues, if planned and developed thoughtfully, it can assist to resolve the most important world's problem of undernutrition and food insecurity in combination with conventional breeding programs. Thank you.